Welcome to our YouTube Story online classroom. I am your Shilpi Miss. So children, let's start our today's activity. And today we are going to learn about soluble and insoluble. So children, what are the things that are soluble and what is a soluble thing and what is a insoluble thing? So let us see. So children, look here. What I have taken? I have taken two glasses filled with water. Two glasses filled with water. I have taken one spoon of salt and I have taken sand. So children, now we will see what is a soluble and what is insoluble. So children, in this glass of water, I will take one spoon of salt and I will. The children, look carefully. What is happening? So what I have done? I have taken one spoon of salt. I have taken one spoon of salt. Or you can also take one spoon of sugar also. So we will mix it in water and we will mix it or we will stir it for some time. So children, you have to take one spoon of salt or one spoon of sugar and you have to put it in the glass of water and you have to stir it for some time. Look, I am stirring it continuously. Okay children, now I am stirring it and stir for some more time and children, look, the salt disappeared. Can you see salt now? No, I have put salt in this water and now you will look, no salt is there. So where is the salt? The salt is dissolved in the water. The salt is dissolved in the water. So now you are not able to see salt. Okay, so now what we will do? We will take this glass of water. Okay, so I am taking this glass of water and I will take one spoon of sand. So children, what is this? This is sand. One spoon of sand. And what I will do? I will put it in the water and I will stir it. So you have to stir it. So let us stir it. So I am stirring it. But children, I am stirring it for so many times. But you will find the sand in our water. Look, it is clearly visible. The sand is not dissolving in the water. Look, you can see sand in the water. So children, sand is not dissolving in the water. You can stir it for some more time. So let us stir it for some more time. Let us stir and again we will check. No, the sand is not dissolving in the water. It settles down at the bottom. You can clearly see the sand is settling at the bottom of the glass. But children, the salt or sugar is completely dissolved in the water and get completely vanished. You cannot see the salt or sugar in the water. But you can see that the sand has settled down in the water. So children, now I am going to tell you that what is a soluble? This salt. The things that get dissolved in water is a soluble thing. The things that get dissolved in water is soluble thing. And children, the things that do not get dissolved in water is insoluble thing. The thing that do not get dissolved in water is insoluble. So salt is soluble and sand is insoluble. soluble. Salt is soluble. Why? Because it gets dissolved in water. And sand is insoluble because it do not get dissolved in water. So children, we will start our next activity, and in our next activity we are going to learn a new shape. So children, look here, which shape is this? It is a diamond shape. It is a diamond shape. And diamond shape has how many sides? Diamond shape has four sides. One, two, three, four. Four sides and four corners. One, two, three, four. Four corners. So children, diamond shape has four sides. And children, do you know when you pull the square shape, you can get the diamond shape? Okay children, and now tell me, which shape is this? These are two triangle shape. These are two triangle shape in my hand. And children, do you know when you will join two triangle, you will get one, which shape is this? One diamond shape. Two triangle shape, when you will join it, when you will join the sleeping side of two triangle shape, you will get one diamond shape. Two triangle shape, one diamond shape. So children, now we have learned about diamond shape, and let us move towards our next activity. And in our next activity, we are going to review lowercase letter E. So children, let us look. So children, this is bed. B-E-D, bed. And I have already told you about this. Now this time, you will tell me, what is the position of E in the word bed? E is in the beginning. Yes. No, E is in the middle. E is in the middle of word bed. So children, let us look our next word, and it is E-A-T, eat. So children, the position of E is in the beginning. Very good. So children, the position of E is in the beginning. Similarly, we will look our next word, and we will find the position of letter E. And what is this? These are eggs. So E-G-G, egg. And E is in the beginning. E is in the beginning. So children, similarly, we will look another word, and it is E-L, E-P-H-A-L. Elephant. And how many E are there? There are two E's, and this E is in the beginning, this E is in the middle. This E is in the beginning position, this E is in the middle position. So children, let us look our next word, and it is elbow. Look, this is elbow. E-L-B-O-W, elbow. And E is in the beginning. E is in the beginning. So children, we will look our next word, and it is engine. E-N-G-I-N-E, engine. So children, what is the position of E? E is in the beginning, E is in the ending position. So children, now we will look our next word, and that is, again it is engine. And now our next word is envelope. Our next word is envelope. So children, E-N-V-E-L-O-P-E, envelope. So children, how many E are there? There are children, now we have reviewed letter E and